Hello, and welcome to your next proficiency test video. This is now the Arri Amira. Last week we did the Arri Alexa. We had our in-class demonstration. Hopefully you went to the workshop, you've built the camera with a team, you know how it works, you love it, you're gonna do your test, you're gonna do great. And now we're gonna move on to the next camera, the Arri Amira. Same sensor as the Alexa, a few differences. We also have two of these cameras. We have two Amiras. They've both been upgraded to 4K, so we can shoot up to 4K on these cameras. Where it changes is in the tripod. So we have a Mitchell tripod that you can see right here, just like the Alexa, also from Miller. This is the Cinex 3 head, really, really beautiful stuff, and it's all brand new. There's no plate, okay? There's no plate, and that's because we have a quick release plate. So that's the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this on the tripod. So just like the Alexa, there's a quick release, slides in diagonal. You can hear the snap. Lock it in, and now the plate is in place. With our other Amira, which is on a 100 mil, by the way, so that's gonna be the same ball mount system that you're used to from first year. So that one has a very similar plate system. So again, you'll be putting the plate on first, and then you'll be snapping the camera into place. If you want more information on how to properly level and balance on a Mitchell system, please refer to the Alexa video. And now let's pop it on, shall we? That's it, it's on. What I love about this quick release system is that we've got we have a plate on the bottom here that's actually attached to a shoulder mount. So if you have to go and get some quick handheld shots, what I love about this system is that you can just pop it off immediately, pop it on your shoulder, and you're good to go. We also have handles that you can take out. They're an additional item. You can attach them to the body of the camera, and then you can really go to town and get some nice handheld shots. Now that we have our tripod and our camera put together, let us put the rest of the camera together, shall we? The big difference here with the Amira over the Alexa, as far as the body of the camera is concerned, is a lot of the buttons are actually on the body of the camera, and it also has the ability for audio, which we're gonna get into a little later. This one has a dedicated eyepiece already attached. It's right here, and there's also a secondary pop-out monitor that also works as your menu system, okay? And again, if you want some practice time with the menu, please go to the Arri website, look at our Blackboard, you'll see the link for it. Their menu simulator system is amazing. So we've kind of fast-tracked a lot of the build here because it's very similar to the Alexa, okay? So the same zoom lens, the same rails, the same follow focus, the same battery, the same monitor, it's all the same throughout the kits. Again, a few small changes here and there. One of the big ones with the Amira is that you can actually have a scratch track mic, okay? So we talked about how there is audio on the side of the camera, and you can see that there are two ports, there's three here, three-pin XLR ports, and that is for you to plug in your microphones. The benefit of the scratch mic is that you can plug this in, you can attach it to the camera, and then you can actually record the audio directly into the camera at the same time. In your post-production classes, Eric will show you how you're going to use this scratch track to give you faster syncing. So you can sync all of your footage lickety-split, and it's all thanks to this. So this is a big benefit that the Amira has over the Alexa. So now we're gonna turn the camera on. It's a little hidden underneath this right here, but the power button is right there. Same with the Alexa, you know it's gonna take a minute to boot up, okay? While we're waiting for the camera to boot up, we can talk about some of the items that, again, you're seeing on the side of the camera. Over here on this flap, this is where your CFast cards are gonna go, and you're gonna get a whole bunch of those in your kit, of course. And you're also gonna see a little spot here with a USB. Don't worry so much about that. That's for software updates and things of that nature. So we take care of that. And now, as you can see, we are good to go. The eyepiece can be adjusted in a few different ways when you're shooting your films on the Amira. There is a lock to allow the item to slide in and out, but on the bottom here, and I'll turn the camera so you can see it a little easier. So you're gonna see this little knob right here, and this is going to allow you to adjust the angle of your eyepiece, okay? This eyepiece also is connected to an EVF, an electronic viewfinder, and that's what you're seeing right here, okay? So we have a few different options for our operator, AC, and everyone involved to take a peek at the footage. So on the top of your EVF are gonna be several buttons. There's a record button on there, as well as some functions. You've got your exposure reading, and you've also got your focus peaking. So you can turn those on quickly on the very top here. Again, a huge advantage over the Alexa. This is so you can just do really quick adjustments. The design of the Amira initially had a very high-end documentary feel, so you could do a lot of adjustments on the fly, which is why you see a lot of buttons and controls physically on the outside body of the camera, as opposed to embedded into the menu system. Press the M button for menu on the top of your EVF, and you will now see down below our menu system. And there are six buttons, three on the top, three on the bottom, and these correspond with your different menu sections. So you can see EI for exposure index, you can see the look of your film, white balance, your shutter, your time code, and your frames per second. There's also the deep menu button, and you do that by pressing the wheel in, and then you can see several other options for different settings. For the recording codec, you're gonna see there's recording, media, monitoring, system, setup, user buttons, and metadata. If you thought recording was where to set your recording codec, you're right, recording codec. And we're gonna be using ProRes 422HQ. This is our desired codec. As of right now, we are going to be shooting HD. But we are putting together upgraded packages with larger, better CF cards, and we're getting drive readers and card readers and all kinds of stuff in the post rooms. So hopefully this will be the year where we can transition to, that's right, shooting in 4K. That is the hope. So for right now, it will either be in HD or it'll be in 4K. So, change the resolution, yes, we're going to confirm, and now it's making that adjustment for us. The next thing is going to be your aspect ratio, and that can be found, just like the Alexa, in our monitoring. So once you're over here, there's your frame lines, and you can change it to 239, 185, whatever you want. That's where you change your frame lines. The next one is going to be, what is the native ISO? Just like the Alexa, we are looking at 800 for the ISO. The next question has to do with your shutter speed and degree. We know all about shutter speeds, and we know what we need to hit to match our frame rates or if we're doing any off-speed shots. But we have the option here of going with angle or speed. Right now you can see the shutter is 1/50. If you prefer working in speeds, you can go to switch unit, and then you can actually change to a shutter speed. Now it's at 176, and we can take it to our standard 180 here. So that is a way of changing over from speeds to angles. I'll do it again for you, and now it's at 148, as you can see. The next one is going to be how to set your camera to its highest frames per second. Your frames per second is right over here, FPS. Click on that, scroll down to the bottom, and as you can see, 200. This camera can shoot up to 200 frames per second. Not too shabby. Let's take it back to 23976, because that's where we like it. The next thing I'm gonna ask you is to explain log C versus rec 709 and how do we set this up in the camera menu. Now, we're gonna be talking about the philosophy between the two in class. We've also covered this in the Alexa video in more detail. But in order to set your looks, you're gonna go to the look button. Okay, and you can see right now we are at the Arri 709. So, we are recording, as you can see, on log C, and that's what we want, okay? But for our EVF, we can take it to look if we want. We can give it the log C, or we can give it the classic Alexa 709 look, and that's definitely what we prefer here. Same with our SDI. So if you want your monitor to give you that same classic 709, you just adjust accordingly, and now you're good to go. So that is how you're going to adjust your settings. And you can see here the recording, the EVF, and the SDI. It's all listed right there, so you can see exactly what you need to do. Setting your exposure for the gray card is done the exact same way as the Alexa, so we're all good there. And when you're doing your white balance is actually right here. And you can see we have all of these different settings with different color temperatures. But the weird thing is, what is this? Kind of looks like the old Ontario Hydro symbol. I have no idea what that is. Well, we're gonna discuss that in just 2 seconds. Okay, because we've also got our EI, and this is where we have our ISOs. And you can see the same sort of thing, okay? What is this all about? We'll get there in 2 seconds. So the next one is the ND filter. This camera has an internal ND filter, which is another reason why we love this camera so much, because we can do a lot of adjustments on the go. The ND filter switch is actually underneath the lens here. Now listen closely when I turn the dial. You can actually hear a new ND coming in front of the sensor. So you're able to adjust your ND on the fly this way, okay? We also have a map box, and we're gonna ask you to change a filter as well, but that's the exact same thing as the Alexa. So again, if you've done the Alexa or if you watched the Alexa video, you already know how this all works. It's the same lens, it's the same everything. So you're good to go. One thing about the buttons that I was just talking about before. You remember how I said when you're on the exposure index or the frames per second, you can actually see there's this weird little sort of almost like a cue and it moves across the different choices. It actually corresponds with these dials over here. So we have a US, we have an EI, we have a WB. Obviously, we know what these are for, but let's just go with the bottom one for now, our white balance. You can see we have 4 options here. If I turn that, it will react with the EVF. It will make the same adjustment on the system here. So I can see exactly what I'm doing. So if my eye is up here, because I can also navigate the menu through this eyepiece as well, then I can make my adjustments and know exactly what I'm setting for on the fly, which is really nice. The automatic white balance button is right below it. Press that button and the camera reacts the exact same way as the Alexa. You're gonna see the little square pop up in the middle of your field of view. You put the gray card in there and then you can set it and you're all good to go. Or you can use the predetermined color settings that are already in the camera, which realistically is gonna be the majority of what you do on this, on your films. We have a 1, 5, 2, 6, 3, 7, 4, 8. These are programmable buttons. So these are like function buttons. So you can do like hotkeys. So you can actually program it and have some quick buttons right here. On top of that, we've also got our audio right here, our left and right. So this is where we can do our adjustments to the audio. That's all done right here. On the opposite side of the camera, this is where you're gonna have your plugins for your microphones. You've also got a plugin for your headphones. And there's a headphone dial right here. And then you have your 3 inputs for your microphones. Input A, B, and C. You will see a 48 volt, you will see a mic, and you will see line. We know what these are for, right? The 48 volt is for phantom. We have a mic and we also have line. Again, remember, if you're plugging a mic in, do not choose line. That is for a preamp and we do not have those here. So please stay away from that setting there. Then on the back of the camera, we have our SDI inputs. We've also got our 12-volt battery. We've got lots of different things for time code and lots of stuff as well. Realistically, for our purposes here, we only really ever use the SDI, but all of these options exist, and we do encourage you to look up all of the functions of this camera. You will be asked to navigate the small menu system, just like the Alexa. Again, watch that video if you want to learn more about how that monitor works. After that, you'll be putting on the matte box, changing the filter, then you're going to record a shot. After that, we're going to format the card, and then we're going to pack it up. So the last thing we got to know is how do we format the card, and that is done in the menu system as well. And what you're going to do is go over to media, and you'll see erase card. It's the first thing that pops up. So no problems there, very simple. That's it. It's a gorgeous camera. It's pretty quick to build and lots of maneuverability here. You can adjust the handle if you want it to recess further back into the body, if you want to keep it further out, you can adjust your plate accordingly. The last thing I want to say is if you do find that the camera is a little loose, you might need to tighten the quick release plate to the plate on your tripod. And if that's the case, we have the screwdriver in your camera kit. Otherwise, again, remember, feather touch and have fun. Any other questions? Again, reach out to our students in the cage. They're there to help you pass this test. Good luck. Again, go to the Arri website and we'll see you for the next video. Thank you.